There we go.
All right.
Now we're live.
So we're live, and everybody missed it. I just kicked Mark right in the mouth. I was welcoming
Mark,
back.
Add that in.
I was welcoming Mark back the old-fashioned way.
I just didn't want you to
Dude,
keep
I'm sorry, man. I am so sorry.
That's what happens when we start trying to do things at the last second, man.
I think Mark was surprised I'd get my leg up that high, actually. Holy cow.
Well, that's not bad. We got everybody moved around. So Mark, come on over here. Shawn, there we go. There you go.
They could be mixed up. All right. I'm not here enough anymore. They don't know me anymore.
Well, listen, Mark, you didn't hear it, but Mike has a theory about you.
What's that?
He thinks he wants to know what's going on between you and Rick, because you're never in the same place at the same time.
He thinks
you're some kind of superheroes
like
or something.
Like Superman and Clark Kent.
That's it.
I love Rick, though. Rick is awesome, man. If Rick is not here, he's doing something important. Let's put it that way.
Well, we like you just as much, if not more.
So that's it. So you got to be sure to get around here as much as you can, too.
The blood bugs, man. Hey, it's biker season.
Oh, I know.
Killing season, all at the
same time.
I took my bike out today to go to the grocery store. I should have left it in the garage. But that's life.
Well, what do we got going on?
Well, I tell you what, we got some great stuff going tonight.
Yep.
We're organized like usual.
Always organized team.
Yep. Look at this. Brittany took care of us. You guys can share that one.
We'll share this one.
And you know what? I can't even read that.
Yeah. You know, I didn't write it.
You guys got the one Brittany wrote so you can read it. Mike and I got the one I wrote, so neither one of us know what else it says.
All right. You want to start?
Sure.
Go ahead.
Brittany and Rick went out on the honor flight, right? So we got some clips of that, and then Brittany's going to come out and talk about the honor flight because it was pretty special. She got to go out with her grandfather.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. That online. That's awesome.
That's pretty cool. And then, Mark, what do you got? You got something after
Traveling Bob. This is a great story. This guy's 68 years old. When he retired, he went out and bought a V-Star. He put 7 suitcases on it, and he travels around the country until his pension runs out. then he sits in a campground until it hits again. And then he takes off.
I want to do that. I want to do that.
Perfect.
This guy's awesome.
That's awesome.
I want to do that.
Then we've got an interview with Pat, our buddy Pat from the Predators.
Yeah.
Right? And we've got Gene and Michelle are going to be out here. We're going to talk to them.
Yeah, we're giving a bike away at the Predator
game.
And
we got something special going on we're going to talk about with them.
Wait. They're giving a bike away, guys.
They're giving it away.
Yes.
What a crazy John's.
Like a hole in one.
What a crazy John's. Crazy ideas.
Not a gift card this time. They're giving you a motorcycle.
Yeah. If you don't make and win the bike, I'll give you a gift card.
There you go.
That's right. And we mean a real motorcycle.
Yeah.
Motor, tires, everything.
Yeah. Matter of fact, I think it's a 2019.
Yes, it is. And we will show that, I believe,
we'll
right?
We'll show that.
We'll be showing that bike as well. We can't play, guys. We can't do it.
Yeah.
So.
I don't have to worry. I couldn't do
it. Yeah, I know.
I couldn't do it.
Then I've been practicing for a month.
See? They said we couldn't bring any ringers in, Mark.
Oh, my God.
So we got the iron pigs.
Back, baby.
We got a clip of the iron pigs.
Yeah.
And then Mike's got something. We got a ride going on our next Saturday.
Not a ride.
It's an event over at Kissimmee.
Armed Forces Day.
Yeah, over at the lake.
Talk about. Then we had some stuff with Leesburg Vice Best.
Yep.
We had to get a little footage out there, so that was a great time as always.
And then we got Leo from Dionysi, if he can make it, because he's working.
Sale, so we'll see.
Before we go any farther, hey John, can you put that title up I asked you to make for me?
What are you afraid he can't stay up till the end of the show?
That's right.
Is that why?
Hey, Willie, happy birthday, you old fart. Now, I'm doing this now, and I'm going to do it after the show when we give our shout-outs, because I'm not sure you'll still be awake.
All right.
And, hey, Willie, I know you'll be awake. Don't worry, brother.
All right, Willie. We'll talk to you later, but you forgot the I after the E. Or between the I. Never mind. Willie, that you'll understand.
I just call him Uncle later. Jimmy.
He wrote what you put on the paper.
That's it. We're lucky it's not dyslexic, backwards, and upside down.
So what do we got here? We're going to do the honor flight?
Yeah, I want to see
let's
this.
Show that clip of the honor flight, and let's get Brittany out here.
All right.
Okay.
to the Psycho Fever TV butt cam.
Right? It wasn't my fault, I swear.
We had two videos with the same label, and one of them was right, one was wrong. Our 50% chance was shot this time.
That's right.
Yes, we lost on that one.
I just want you to tell everybody what you did that day, because what she did was awesome. What happened that day was awesome. This is the Honor Flight.
Honor Flight, Central Florida. I took my 94-year-old grandfather, Gerard Fernandez Jr., out to D.C. on Saturday, and it was one of the most incredible experiences I've ever had in my entire life. And I know it's the most amazing thing, one of the most amazing things he's ever done. I highly recommend anybody that can do it, do it. So, what do you guys want to know?
Tell everybody what the Honor Flight is, because there might be some people out there
that
don't know what it is yet.
Very cool. So what Honor Flight does is they basically take veterans at no cost to them to D.C. for the day so that they can go visit their memorials, especially if they've never seen that. And in my case, with my grandfather never saw his memorial, so I had the pleasure of being able to take him to see it for the first time ever. He got to see his Pacific Front, and I don't know if you guys saw the picture of him in front of the star. Well, there we are with Bob Dole.
Bob Dole, look at that. Very cool.
That's my grandpa with Bob Dole. The most amazing thing about that whole thing right there is my grandfather said to Bob Dole, he says, "Mr. Dole, I went to one of your fundraisers several years ago and had the chance to meet you. It was quite lovely." And Mr. Dole's shaking his hand. He goes, "Well, I guess I owe you some money then, don't I?"
Hey, he's still got a good sense of humor.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does. But it's an amazing thing. It's at no cost to the veterans. The guardians are asked to give a donation to help with the cost of the flight and everything for the veterans. But again, it's to take these veterans from, I believe it's 46 states that do this across the country. And we were fortunate enough to be around the San Diego flight, which we lost one of the veterans just an hour outside San Diego. He passed away, but he completed his mission. He got to see his memorial, and I do recall seeing him throughout the day.
Yeah.
And it was sad to see that he passed away, but he did complete his mission thanks to Honor Flight, which is incredible. So thank you, Honor Flight, for doing that for all these veterans.
And Ed and his wife.
Yes, Ed and Nancy.
Nancy.
Oh, my God. Ed and Nancy, I cannot thank you enough for doing this for us, but for all of them in Central Florida and all across the United States. Thank you so much.
Yeah, no, thanks, guys.
I believe if you go to honorflight.org or is it .com, you know?
I want to say .org.
Yeah, I think it's .org. But anyways, if you go to Psycho Fever TV after the show, we'll find it. We'll put it up on our website so you can see it. That's CFTV Live now.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yes.
CFTVLive.com.
So. Yep. Yep.
So great. Well, I'm glad you had a good time.
Yes, it was amazing.
Spent some quality time with your grandfather. Once in a lifetime.
I did. And he loved it so much. Now, the thing is with veterans, they get a little nervous about going, especially the older ones. But we, you know, got him through it, you know, talked him into going. And once he went, he had an amazing time. He had such an amazing time. He's actually wanting to donate money to Honor Flight. And he also wants to become actively involved with Honor Flight at some capacity. And this is my 94-year-old grandfather who got to experience this. And he loved it that much. And he got to see what they do for all these guys firsthand.
Fantastic.
Yes.
All right, Brie, I know how excited you were about it.
It was amazing.
You've been talking about it, so it was great.
Yes.
So with that, we're going to let you lead us in. What do we got? We've got another clip coming up.
Is that what, Traveling Bob?
That'd be
Traveling Bob.
Bob.
Hey everybody, this is Mark. We're out here at the Horizons Unlimited rally still, and I'm here with Bob. When Bob pulled in, I think he got the most attention of anybody else that came in here. If you can, Bob, tell us a little bit about your bike and a little bit about what you got going on here, because I'm going to take some pictures, and while you're talking about it, I'm going to be showing them. So.
Okay. Well, it's a V-Strom 650, and I got a lot of luggage. It's my luggage mobile, and that's because I like the luxury of space, which you don't have much in a motorcycle. Also, I use it for work, so I used to carry my tools and so forth, and it made it easy when I work in New York City to bring stuff in, find parking, and get out of there. So on this trip, I got a lot of luggage, but it's not all full. It's like there's extra space because you always have to have extra space. I like it more.
You never know when you're going to pick up something, huh?
I try not to. But then the problem it's just remembering where you put things.
Yep. I never thought about that before.
Oh, yeah. Look. I've got zippers galore here. I've got an inventory sheet which just lists the zippers, you know, so I know where to go to find my stuff. So I'm very good with zipper maintenance. And I not only do I oil the chain, I oil my zippers.
Yeah, I never thought about that either. So when you're out, I mean, how many miles a day can you get with all your stuff on here?
Well, no.
Or how many do you try to, how many do you try to do, put it that way?
As few as possible.
As few as possible.
Because, like, then you're, I don't like riding on a schedule. Now, I had, because of Florence, I was delayed coming down here. I didn't want to ride through the storm. So I got down here on 2 days. My trip is going to be like 5 or 6 weeks. And I'll try for 100 miles a day. And because, like, the less the better.
Yeah,
I'm a tourist. I can ride all year round, you know, even without heat. I mean, I know how to layer myself and so forth. I'm used to it, and I'm fine doing that. And I'll tell you, these hand warmers, they're the best, you know, because that's a problem.
Yeah, they're good for heat.
Extremities.
In the sun, they block the...
Exactly, because I'm fair-skinned, and the sun is a problem. So it blocks the sun, too. And it gives you a couple extra zipper compartments, you know? More storage, the better.
Bob, thank you very much. It's people like you that make the motorcycle world exciting.
Okay, well, it's an exciting place to be.
Yep.
Hey, everybody. I think we got the audio back.
I think they
can hear us.
There
we go. All right, man. So tell us about that ride.
Real quick, when I met this guy, he was so old school to me. When I edited, I was wanting to look like an old TV show when I talked to him.
I like that, man. I had the feel to it.
Bob was one of the most awesome people I met. I was on a Horizons Unlimited run. The Horizons Unlimited is a group of people. They travel around the world on motorcycles. It's a great website to check out. But Bob, literally, he gets $1,700 a month. He'll ride from campground to campground until that $1,700 runs out. And then he just stays there. He hangs out there, and then when he gets another $1,700, he rides to the next campsite. He's happy with 200 miles a day. Bob is awesome.
That's cool. I love it.
Yep.
So, now, where was that at?
There was Iron Horse Lodge in North Carolina when we did that interview. Yep.
Now, this was one of your rides that you take people out on, right?
That was the weekend. And if you go on my channel, you'll see I do a video where I talk about leaving Orlando to go to the Pennington Poker Run in Key West, and then going the next day to North Carolina for the Horizons Unlimited interviews. So that was an iron butt day.
Yeah, I guess, man. I bet.
Yes.
So tell people how they can hook up with you to go on these rides.
If you go to againstthewindfl.com, you can find me there. You can also find me at Riding and Flying with Mark Hall on YouTube.
All right.
So, anyways, I want to get to this interview here because this is exciting.
I like how you're being modest, man. You don't have to rush through that. Listen, if you guys get a chance, hop on there with Mark and take a ride, man, because he does some great stuff and you get some great footage and you have a great time. So
check it out. Everything's, when you pay for a ride, if you don't have a bike, we can provide a bike. It includes all your gas. It includes your room. We have a 3-day trip that leaves out of Orlando, goes to, over to Venice Beach, where you take a ride on a sailboat, and then we come back the next day through the swamp, the green swamp, and the clear water and stuff like that. It's a nice ride.
I always have a blast riding with you, man. I know you take care of those people and you have some good stuff going on. All right, well, like you said, we got something coming on here. We got an interview, right?
Yeah, and this is where they're giving away this bike.
That's. So we got Dad's got some guests he's going to bring out here right now. Let's see where he's at.
I'm going to let them talk about this because I just want to look at this motorcycle for a little bit.
You check it out, man. You check it out. All right, so we got some guests with us here.
You ain't going to believe what I found.
You found our buddy Pat. How you doing, buddy?
Very well.
I'm going to stand right here behind all of you because my voice carries.
Hi
now,
there.
Before we start, okay.
Gotcha.
We got Pat. Is this Jean?
Yes.
Okay, and that's
Michelle.
That's like the Michelle. Anyhow, these two girls wrecked my crew after the last game. Where were you, Dexter's?
No, this isn't them.
This isn't them?
No.
Where'd you run into?
They're taking us out drinking after this game.
Oh!
See, we gotta space ourselves without.
It shows you how much they tell me about this show.
See? Latitudes. After the game. Latitudes.
Latitudes.
That's
Every home game at halftime, we're going to choose two lucky fans. They're going to punt to win a motorcycle that's
sitting right over there.
Yeah, we'll show you. We'll right show you what it looks like.
Yep. You got the opportunity. You got the chance. As long as you're not a professional athlete, you can possibly make it happen. Drive away in that bad boy right there.
Yeah, you got to be 18 years old to play.
18 years old.
Not a professional athlete.
You're going to be a Predator fan.
It's like a hole in one.
Exactly.
Except it's a football in the cart.
It's going to be a 35-yard punt into a shopping cart. That ball's got to stay in that shopping cart, and you can drive away in that beautiful motorcycle right there.
With that being said, let me go grab Dante.
Wait, before that.
Okay.
Of course, whose brainchild was this?
Crazy John
would come up with something like this. Of course, they're out on a family vacation. Hey, Janie's. So he couldn't be here tonight, and it's killing him because he won't be at the game either. But this is a Crazy John production.
Yeah.
So he came up with
here.
And they all fell for it.
You guys stay right there. I want you to get up here. Everybody, this is Dante.
How's it going,
guys? You were from iMotorsports?
iMotorsports at 1150 Jetport Drive over in Orlando, Florida. I guess we're giving away a bike.
That's it.
Pretty excited about that. We've got a couple of different options over at the store. The bike I brought here today is a 2017 Chieftain Dark Horse.
This is his personal bike. We're not giving this bike away.
You're not getting mine.
Because he'll be a little agitated. And you can see by the size, Pat doesn't want to deal with that.
We don't want to make him mad.
So, yeah. But
so tell us a little bit about the bike. Dark Horse.
So the Chieftains come with a 111 cubic inch motor. They're 119 foot-pounds of torque. 6-speed transmission, they're fast, quality bike. As you can tell from this motorcycle itself, there's a lot of aftermarket available for it. This one's got the stage 2 exhaust, intake, cams. It's got the 19-inch wheel up front. It's got electronic windshields. There's a lot of customization you can get on these motorcycles. They all come with a 2-year unlimited mileage warranty. All of our new motorcycles from iMotorsports are going to come with a 1,000,000-mile powertrain warranty.
Wow.
It's an industry, you don't see it out in the industry, 1,000,000 miles. So we also have a full service shop. We don't sell just Indians. We sell Vanderhalls. I got used bikes. We're a large company with 3 different locations, 859 motorcycles between the 3 of them. So chances are, if we don't have what you're looking for in my store, I've got it in another store. You can get it down here in a couple of days. We're with a lot of wholesalers. So whatever you're looking for, give us a call. We'd be more than happy to bring it in. You guys are moving these cameras around. I don't know what
you're doing. That's IT John switching cameras. So you just look straight ahead and we'll worry.
Perfect.
Now, what they're doing is they're trying to find Dad's best side. That's why it keeps
changing all the
time.
And they can't find it.
They can't find it.
We need a camera from the back.
That's it.
That won't even work. But now, you're going to be there Sunday.
I will be there
with
Sunday.
With our 13 bikes, right? We got 15 bikes are coming out. And we're going to ride out the Dancers, the Claw, whatever else. The bike.
So.
You girls.
But.
Tell you what, we'll work something out for the next game.
Okay.
But we have.
Because he'll have to get a couple extra bikes, and he's going to have to get a couple extra tickets for the bikers.
Yeah, it's some okays.
But that's a good promotion.
That is. It's great.
You know
what?
Pick 2 people that can ride out the next game.
Perfect.
Here we go.
I like it.
I think we have 2 people right here that want to do it.
Yeah. And we can be bought, right?
Yeah.
They
can definitely
be
bought.
I have that wooden nickel. I got the wooden nickel for you.
There you go.
Right.
Hey, don't spend it all in one place. But
no, I'm
so
warn you.
Hey, she knows Kenny, so you gotta.
I'm gonna warn you.
She
you
caught
that crazy John.
Have not
but
been
he
crazy
will
John.
Be there. Not this game. He will be there in the next game. You guys will be like this.
Yeah.
No problem.
Yeah. Yeah. So, you and crazy John will fit right in.
Yeah.
Definitely.
But we're lucky enough, so we ride the Dancers in every game. We never bitch about that. And we have a great time with Claw and Pat and everybody. So it's Sunday. Game's at 5.
5 o'clock.
5
Sunday,
o'clock.
Mother's Day.
It's Mother's Day, so bring your mom. We'll have a great time. We'll get her on the camera there. And then the next game is the 30th.
May 31st. It's a Friday night, May 31st. Friday.
Before I forget, let me whisper this in your ear to make sure it's okay.
Saying anything.
All right, this is what we're going to do now. Pat, I introduced you to Warriors on Water.
Yes.
Okay, that's a cancer survivor group. If anybody's got a group that hasn't talked to Pat yet, Pat will get you free tickets to the game for your group. Is that correct?
That is correct. That is correct.
115,000 people. We have to set limits.
But if you go up on our website after, we'll have Pat's information.
Absolutely.
If that's all right with you.
Absolutely.
I'll put your business card up there. So if you got a group, there's the pink, the ladies who ride the
ribbon rider, really, the stilettos.
Ribbon riders.
Yeah, I don't know if you haven't heard from them, but they're a great group.
Yes.
There's a whole bunch of groups that we get together. Mark, can you think of one?
Pink
no, I
ladies.
Know the pink ladies. I see them like on Friday night about 12:30.
I was talking about the cancer survivor.
Right.
There it is.
Yep.
So reach out to Pat.
Absolutely.
And I thought Pat was smarter than to give us his information, but I guess not.
We had a good autism awareness group down.
Yes.
There's all sorts of stuff we can do. So
absolutely.
There we go.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, with that being said, ladies, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We'll see you.
Yeah.
Hold on one second.
Let him stop yapping. Okay, go ahead.
I want to give a shout out. This Saturday at Boardwalk Bowl, we're doing a bowl with the Predators. All right, we're going to have the Orlando Predator players there. We're going to have the Predator dance team there from 4 to 7, Boardwalk Bowl over on East Colonial Drive. For the fans, you come in and say you're here for the Predators. You pay $10. It's unlimited bowling from 4 to 7. Shoes are included. Bowl with your favorite Predator. Bowl with your favorite Predator Prowler dance team member. And then after that, you know who you're going to be cheering for this Sunday at the game.
He don't want to talk.
I mean, Sunday, 5 o'clock, Amway Center. Be there. If you're not going to be there.
Catch it on Cycle Fever.
Catch it on Cycle Fever TV. Absolutely.
Yep.
Thank you.
Now, Mark's
Thank
got
you.
Something.
Oh, yeah.
We need the bumpers. That's an extra $5.
Brittany will tell you, we did something for, the Boys and Girls Club?
It was for
Big Brothers, Big Sisters. I didn't break 100.
Neither did I. Don't feel bad.
Actually, some of the Big Brothers and Big Sisters are coming to the game on Sunday as well.
Outstanding.
That's fantastic.
All right. Well, so what we got next?
We've got the Iron Pig.
All right.
Bye, ladies.
We didn't let you go
yet. We didn't say you can leave yet.
Don't leave me here with these guys.
Okay, see you later.
Now
you can go.
Bye.
All right. Bye, ladies.
What a help.
Thank you so much.
All right, buddy. We'll see you Sunday.
Yes, absolutely.
Get over here, Mark. Mark.
All right.
So, thanks, Dante. All right. See, we have too much fun over here.
Come right over here.
Mark was biting his tongue over there.
He had
something smart he wanted to say.
He was trying to keep Dante busy over here.
Yeah.
So they could leave
that's
the
exactly what
I do want to point out one thing that I'm here. I seen Rick on the show tonight. It was just his backside, but we didn't see him. So there you go.
So we made it on the show tonight. There it is.
We had him on the new Cycle Fever TV butt cam.
And I can't wait to see the next video because this is a great group. They do such good charity work with the hospitals. It's amazing.
All right, Iron Pigs.
All right.
Start up your engines, getting ready to roll. Gonna cruise on my bike now, music to the soul. Kickstand up, boots are best. Ain't gonna touch down till the road comes to rest. We're riding country roads, enjoying the day. We're riding for the love of the U.S. of A. So catch a cycle fever, don't let it slip away. We're rocking the blues, it's the bike away. Thursday night is bike night at the A's Cafe. Broadcasting live, you know it's time to play. Rock and roll music and grooving to the blues. Classic cars shimmying while it's sipping the breeze. So catch the cycle fever, don't let it slip away. We're rocking the blues, it's a bike away. Sturgis, trying to reach Biker Week somewhere just down on the beach. There's Daytona Speedway in the USO. The ride you never heard of, so get ready to go. We're riding country roads and enjoying the day. We're riding for the love of the US of A. We're flying our colors, enjoying the view. The pride we ride for the red, white, and blue. We got the club logo on our back. We don't need much when it's time to pack. We ride for causes and charities. From Boggy Creek, to the Florida Keys. We're riding country roads, enjoying the day. We're riding for the love of the U.S. of A. We're flying our colors, enjoying the view. With pride we ride for the red, white, and blue. So catch a cycle fever, don't let it slip away. We're rocking the blues, it's a microwave. Yeah, yeah, the microwave.
Caught with the mic,
because
hey, we're not allowed
it's
to talk.
Thing that we get caught with it off and not caught with it.
I know, because yeah. I get yelled at every show. We leave it on. I drop F bombs. Everybody back here, and then I get in trouble.
Oh,
so,
what can I tell you?
Well, Mark, you're gonna head out.
Yeah,
you got some stuff
I
got
to work
on.
Early in the morning. I just want to say thanks to the Iron Pigs because them guys are awesome for everything they do, man.
They are.
They are.
And, very cool.
We'll see you guys next Thursday.
Yeah. Well, we'll see you
Sunday.
Sunday.
Predators game. Predators game.
All right.
Wait. I can't see without my glasses.
There you go.
All right, buddy. Tell Kim bye. All right. So, we got. So now we're gonna see. Rick's gonna come walking in.
Any second now.
So now we got. We got something coming up. Not this Saturday. The following Saturday. So why don't you tell everybody about that?
Okay. May 18th is Armed Forces Day. We will be there streaming live for that day, for the Armed Forces Day. They have a live band, Harlequin, to be playing, which, from what I've seen so far, they're really, really good. They got a lot of vendors. This is their annual event. This has been the event for the city of Kissimmee now, every year.
It's at the lakefront. It's where they launch the boats.
It's at the lakefront.
From 2 to 7.
From 2 to 7. So,
we will be there.
We will be there. Come
right
up and
next
see
to
us
you.
And find us. Huh?
Right next to you
right
in the USO.
I'll be there with the USO.
All right.
So. Talking about the USO, you got something different going this year. Give me a date first.
September 21st.
All right, everybody mark that one down. September 21st.
Yep.
Now, you're not going out of the same place, so where are you going out of this time? Sure. Osceola County Soccer Complex.
No.
Right?
I'm going to have a drink.
What do you mean, no? It's a soccer complex.
It's a soccer complex. See, you caught me off guard again.
Oh, jeez. Anyhow, it's off of Boggy Creek Road.
I'm going to tell you where it's at.
He's going to tell me where it's at. Anyhow, it's a different area. Mike went out and scouted it. Looks like everything's going to be pretty neat. We should have some fun. And he's still looking, so
we'll
hold him up. Mike, what's happening?
You're not supposed to get me off guard.
Oh, my goodness.
He does that to everybody. Don't worry about it.
So let's you and I talk. So, I hear you went and visited your two grandmothers.
I did visit my two grandmothers.
Want to just give them a shout-out while
I'm going to do that at the end.
At the end?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
See, he's trying to trip everybody up.
Yeah.
It's Austin Tindall Sports Complex.
Yeah, the soccer complex.
But the official name is Austin Tindall.
No, yes,
we're
sports complex.
Here we go, Brittany. All right. Well, everybody, hopefully, IT John, can you throw that back up there one more time? People get another good look at it. Maybe you can't hear me.
Find it.
You probably see. We're throwing everybody
there
up. There
it
is. All right. So there it is, the lakefront. There's the address. It's from 2 to 7 p.m. Everybody get out there and have a good time. So it's a fun time. All right. Well, we did our annual Leesburg Bike Fest.
Wait a minute.
What?
We didn't. You, Mike.
Unfortunately, Dad was sick. Mike, where were you?
I was at Eustis Bike Fest.
And then I went
to Leesburg. Then I went back to Eustis. Then went back to Leesburg.
So then me, Crazy John, and Brittany.
Oh yeah.
We headed out to Leesburg. You know, we tried to leave early. Crazy John and I were tired. We didn't want to leave. You know, we were ready to go at, like, I don't know, 8 o'clock. Brittany's going, no, we can't go. You know, I got to have some fun. Woo, 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 all that stuff. So we just hung out because of Brittany. It was all because of Brittany. Her husband, I don't know if he was sick or she fed him something. You know, so IT John couldn't make it. So it was the three of us, so let's see what kind of shenanigans we got into.
We got a big bug flying in front of us.
We do.
We'll have to talk to the pest control.
I earned my patch at Eustis Bike Fest by riding that loop so much going around. They gave me a patch that says, you rode the loop
at
Eustis Bike Fest.
Nice.
So Now explain a little bit about it, because that's on the other side of the lake.
On the other side of the lake, it was their third annual. They had Friday night was Jeff Howe played, and then on Saturday night was Quiet Riot.
Okay.
Which was a really, really good band. Which good. I seen them back in the 80s when I was really young.
Yeah, me too. Me too. I saw the Quiet Riot and Iron Maiden together.
Oh, that was awesome.
Yeah, that was nuts. All right, well, IT John, go ahead, throw it to Leesburg. Everybody, Shawn here, Cycle Fever TV, out at our favorite Leesburg Bike Fest, and look who I found here. Paul Senior's here in the house. Oh,
thank you.
Hey, great to see you.
Thank you. Great to be here.
Everybody's crowding around you. I'm like, there's got to be some superstar here. I can see the line out there.
It's the mustache.
Is that it?
Yeah,
it's the mustache.
That's the attraction.
Well, listen, is this your first Leesburg Bike Fest?
Yeah, it is. My first. We tried to get here a couple times before this, but you know, we've been filming and stuff. It's crazy. Our schedule's crazy. But this year, you know, we made sure that we got here.
That's fantastic. You made a little room for such a great event. So, and everybody loves you. You're a fan favorite, so that's great.
Yeah.
And did you bring some bikes in, too? I'll get some shots of those.
Yeah, I've got a few more coming.
Do you?
Yeah, ours. We're going to be riding in tomorrow.
Oh, all right. Fantastic. That's great. So, I catch you. What time are you going to be riding through?
I think we're going to get here around 1 or so. 1 or so tomorrow, yeah.
All right. So, there you go. That'll be something everybody will want to see for sure. Now, I know you got a lot of stuff going on, been doing a lot of filming. So, how does everybody get to see you out there now?
Back at home?
Yeah.
We do tours, 5, 6, 7 tours a day. So, when people come into the retail store, we have like restaurant, we have all the games, and it's like it's crazy.
Oh man,
it's crazy. But yeah, there's a lot going on.
You're always a busy man, that's for sure. Well, listen, we appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you.
Mandy asked you for a few minutes for us, and we really appreciate that. So hey guys, look at this. Cycle Fever TV, Paul Senior, and we're gonna have some of his great bikes out there. It was a pleasure. Thank you, sir.
Thank you for taking the time.
All right, thank you.
Ready? At the Leesburg Bike Fest this year with the Ink Girls, and I know I ran into you last year. I was a little aggravated. Shawn wouldn't let me interview you. He did, but this year I get the interview. So tell us a little bit about the Ink Girls, what you guys do, and if you're having a good time.
Well, we always have a great time here at the Leesburg Bike Fest. We love coming out, not only to enjoy the fest, but to meet everybody here, take the pictures. This is actually the first year we are mobile. So every other year we've had a booth, we've had a stationary place. Yes, we have gone around, but this year we have no booth, so we get to move around a little bit more, go to all the different places. There's only 3 of us here this year, whereas past years we've had 4, sometimes 5 girls.
Yep.
But we decided to do it with 3 this year. So I'm Taylor. As you met me last year. So I'm actually here. This will be my third year.
All right.
Yeah. And then to my right here, this is the beautiful Magda.
Magda. First year?
First year. I'm a first timer. Popping
newbie.
My cherry. I've never even been on a motorcycle.
Really?
Never. So I'm trying a lot of new things this weekend.
All right. I'm sure somebody will take you for a ride. I promise you.
Sounds good.
Right? And then to her right.
I'm Tiana. Hi. I'm also new here. This is my first time, so I'm just waiting for somebody to let me ride their bike.
There you go.
Now that the party is underway, with the bass kick feeling and the bass drum, quick to the point though. Look at them bees like a pounder. Burning them, you ain't quick and nimble. I go crazy when I hear a cymbal and a hi-hat with a souped up tempo. On a roll, time to go solo. In my 5.0, back top down so my head can blow. Charlie's going 10 by, waving to the day high. Nah, just drove by, kept going. Let's go on to the next stop. That's a new door.
you drinking and Crazy John. That's all that we can attest to.
You know, we got Crazy John and we got Wild Brittany.
Yeah.
Whitney. Oh, no. Whitney.
Oh, that's her stage name. Yeah. That's what we're only supposed to call her that in Leesburg.
Oh. Yes.
She's Brittany here with us.
I got to tell you, I have tons and tons of footage. So we'll see what happens.
Listen, you know, Paul Sr. was really cool.
Oh,
that was great. Got to talk to him, but he was.
I was surprised that he was as cordial and as nice as he was.
He was very nice.
Because when you see him on the show, when he's banging computers,
I was waiting for him to say, "You want me to kick you in the ass with your size 10s?" I was like, "No, thank you." But you know, he was great.
He was great.
He was great. Then John got to interview the Ink Girls, and we didn't see it, but he had his buddy Tasha, XOXO, on there.
Okay.
She was on there, and then Vanilla Ice.
That was a blast.
He was really good, guys. I got to tell you.
Ice baby. Yes.
I had to try and warn Scott. Scott was up front getting footage, and someone warned us, he comes out and shoots water. I go, no, all over the camera. I'm like, Scott, get away from there. He shoots water out, and he did.
Yep.
He put on a great show, and before that show went on, I was over there with Nova Rex, so
yep.
I got that.
Yep. We'll have them on next week.
On. Kenny
cool.
and the crew, that was fantastic. You know, we had a great time. Then I come back and I see her up on stage, you know, she's dancing with Crazy John up there. So we all had a good time, but yeah, I laugh because Brittany goes, I don't know how long I'm going to stay. We couldn't get her to leave.
It's true. I do this every time. I had a blast. Vanilla Ice was way better than I thought it would have been.
He was funny.
I saw that footage.
Yes.
He was funny. I came home, I told my wife, I said, I really liked him. He was pretty good. I liked the way he was talking about how the dancing, all the stuff between the 80s
and the 90s,
and
the block parties, everything, how it used to go down.
Yep.
Yeah. And I liked what he said. I wrote this song when I was 16 years old.
That's right.
Ice Baby. Yep. That was it. No, so that was pretty cool. So. Listen, I don't know if Leo's going to make it out. He had that big sale he was doing.
Yeah, he was working on something.
So,
he had an
event coming up this weekend, and I don't know what it was. He had something coming up this weekend, and the person that knows about it is Mike. Mike went to go check on him. So, I don't know. I think here's where we throw it to IT John and say, hey, do we got a clip of something you can just throw up there, and we'll talk about it later.
Yeah, we'll try that.
Okay, right. Sounds good.
But let's, because we're going to stall a little bit.
Okay.
We'll stop. Well, that's one thing we're good at.
That is.
So, Brittany.
Yes.
Outside of all the ass shots that you guys took for the honor flight.
Yes.
Yeah, the honor flight.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit, like, what time you had to get up, the delays, all of this stuff.
Okay,
and how your grandfather really didn't want to go until he went. Kind of like you.
Yes,
I don't want to do this. Oh, this is so much fun.
Okay, so under Flight Central Florida, we go up for one day. So they have us meet there at 3:45 in the morning. So my husband and I were smart about this. We said, let's get a hotel room. So we stayed just outside of the airport so that I could get up at 2 to be at the airport at 3:45 and that my grandpa could be at the airport at 4. We didn't take off until around 6 o'clock, land around like 8:20, that sort of thing. And as soon as we land, there's like this huge greeting party there for all the veterans. Everybody's saying thank you for your service. It's like, it's this incredible, amazing experience. And as soon as we get out of the airport, we're on that bus and we're going straight to Arlington to go watch the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, Changing of the Guard, which was absolutely incredible. If you ever have a chance to see it, please do. It's solemn, sacred ground, so of course it's a quiet thing that you have to go do. It's a very emotional thing, but it was something I will never forget. And then as soon as we were done with the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, we went over to the Air Force Monument Memorial, and that's incredible. That's brand new. I mean, it's way up there. It's very disorienting to look at. And as a matter of fact, my grandfather, in his wheelchair, the paramedic, like, leaned back like this. He's like, okay, that's enough. It's enough. Because it's that high up.
Popping wheelies in the wheelchair, huh?
My grandpa was popping some hot wheelies with the paramedic. So then after that, we went to the National Mall, which is where the Lincoln Memorial is, and also, or Monument, I should say, and the World War II Memorial is directly across from the Lincoln Monument, which is absolutely incredible. And that's where Mr. Dole sits outside of, because he helped bring that memorial to life. He helped make that possible. So thank you, former Senator Dole, for making that memorial possible, along with all the other people that helped contribute to make that possible. Because now my 94-year-old grandfather and so many other World War II vets that are still around have the opportunity, or have had the opportunity, to see that since 2004. And then, of course, you also have the Vietnam Wall to look at, and the newest addition to the National Mall, which would be the Korean War Memorial, which is one of the most amazing things I've ever seen. Like, all the memorials are awesome, but that one's just got like a little bit of more of a chilling, haunting thing to it, because there's actual statues of men going through the rice paddies, and it looks like you're there in the moment with it. It's something special. So if we ever do get the right clip on, you guys will be able to see the footage I shot of these monuments and memorials. Please do, if you ever have a chance, go see it. It's amazing. Unfortunately, we did have a delay because the weather was so bad here. We did lose a couple of hours there, but our plane was coming from here to there to pick us up, and the weather was so bad here. That's why we lost some time, but we didn't get home until about 10:30 we landed at night, and there was a big welcoming home party. It was unbelievable. Please, if you ever have a chance, and again, thank you to Nancy and Ed Reardon for this. They do such an amazing job. I cannot explain to you what an amazing experience this is for anyone, whether it's a family, a friend, or somebody that you don't know. If you can volunteer to be a guardian, or if you can, you know, nominate somebody, or you know, send in, you know, somebody that you want to have do this, please do it. Don't hesitate. Don't wait. Our veterans are so important. God bless all of them. And, you know, like our slogan says, we don't know all of them, but we owe them all.
Yeah,
that's good. Do. You know, your husband was right. Two things. Number one, I can't get blamed for him for the wrong clip, which is usually me. And John did say, if you want to fill a gap, just ask my wife. Right, John? Look, see?
He's giving me thumbs up.
Well, you know who to talk to about the correct clips, right? You have a contact for that, right?
For the correct clips?
Yeah.
My husband?
Yeah, I do.
I have, you know, IT John. I guess I'm still attached to him. So, you know, my husband, good guy. He knows what's going on sometimes.
Hey, I found
in here.
I found Mike.
Scoot on.
Mike says, don't worry about it.
All right.
Don't worry about it.
Leo.
Mike, where you going now? Oh, the end?
Might as well now.
Just walk through the shot.
So Leo can't make it. We'll try to give him next time. Do you know the event that he had going on this Saturday?
He said no.
That's a different kind of event, but I don't have any specifics. So listen, you can contact Dionysio Orlando and find out what they got going on this week.
Go in and see Leo.
Hey, Leo, you were too busy to come out, which is a good thing because he's in there making sales. That's always a great thing.
All right. Well, so a couple things. Number one, pretty good show tonight.
Not bad.
Not bad.
Rick didn't screw anything up.
No, Rick was the best of all of us.
Yeah. Yeah, he was pretty good. So, Mike, you got any ending words?
Any shout-outs?
I got one.
Yeah?
To my lovely wife for putting up with me for so much.
Yeah,
we love you, you gotta
do more than that for your wife. Let me tell you something. That's not quite enough. So, what about you? I think you're gonna try the birthday thing one more time.
Put up Willie, will you?
All right. There it is.
Look, Willie. Two things. I know that you're an old fart. And I know you're getting old, and you don't like birthdays anymore. But look at the bright side of things. We've known each other since third grade. We're still kicking. And I'm still older and smarter than you.
Well, okay. I was going to say, look at the bright side. He's still older than you. I wasn't going to throw in the smarter part. He did that on his own.
Happy birthday, Willie.
Happy birthday, Jimmy.
Happy birthday, Willie.
There we go. See? Now, I've got a couple of shout-outs. I was in upstate New York, Rochester, last week. I was lucky to see both of my 99-year-old grandmothers.
Oh, wow.
So
nice.
It helps if they're both in the same place. Oh, yeah, my wife's not happy. She thinks I'm going to live forever. So my grandmother Hastings just had her 99th birthday. My grandmother Ruff had it a month ago. But Grandma Hastings, happy birthday. And she spent it in the hospital because the day before, the day I got there, she tripped doing jazzercise and broke her hip. So she was exercising at 99, broke her hip.
Keep it
real. But I got to tell you, she was up They had her up out of the bed in 5 hours. She was up on the walk. That's crazy. Wow.
That's impressive.
Tonight, right now, today, the whole day, is my sister Allison's birthday. Allison, love you. Happy birthday. There you go.
Happy birthday, Allison.
Too. I didn't spell that one.
Yep. There you go. So we got that one right.
Happy birthday, Allison.
There we go. And then my youngest daughter, one of his granddaughters, is in Australia right now.
That's so cool.
So it's in the morning right now. So it's 9, 10, 11 a.m.
Good morning.
So there you go. So Ellie, Elise, hope you're having a great time in Australia. So
remember
Elise,
what I told you.
Elise is down under and you're having a blast.
Just make sure you bring him something cool.
She's been sending some fantastic pictures.
That's been awesome.
Great.
I can only tell you this. When I was in college, our field trip went from the classroom to the library.
That's about right.
Yeah, that was it.
Yep. All right.
And I still got the statue from the library that I borrowed.
I bet. I would say he had a bunch of books he still owes the library, but I know he didn't read that much.
Oh, my God. What's the interest on those?
It's only one book.
They don't know I have it.
Exactly.
See Dick Run.
Was that in a tablet?
No, it's
five.
Exactly.
I failed.
Mike had it right. It was in tablet form.
Yes.
So.
Cuneiform for the Sumerians.
I hope this makes you feel younger.
Well, I think we should do that one together. I would really quick like to say, Grandpa, I love you. Thank you for doing Honor Flight with me. That was the best day ever. Love you.
All right. I'm glad you got to go, Grandpa. So that's really cool. All right, we've got one that we're going to do for everybody.
Yes, everybody needs to do this one.
So from all of us here at Cycle Fever TV, right?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
So it's coming up on Sunday. We will be at the Predators game. Hopefully you guys can come out to the Predators game. Bring your mothers, but to all the mothers out there.
Yep.
Happy Mother's Day! We hope you guys have a great one. Have a fantastic Mother's Day. And I think we can close the show out now.
Shall we?
All right. We will see you in 2 weeks if we don't see you at the Predators game.
That's right.
And remember, you can win a bike. 2019 Chieftain.
Yes, and if you want to see the Predators game and you're not going, go to CFTV.live or Cycle Fever TV. And you will see the game. We're streaming it live.
We're streaming
Absolutely.
It. All right, so let's end this puppy.
That's right.
All right.
You ready?
All right, everybody.
Join the adventure and enjoy the ride.
We'll see you
soon. See you guys.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
All right.